Here goes the PLL full bridge. Haven't played with it in a while. Coil right there. Rewound a new high power primary for it. Also had to wind this higher impedance primary for trying to run smooth continuous wave. I wanted to see how music would work out. What I also did with this driver is I just kind of did the same thing I've done with a couple other ones where I just nixed the hex inverter. So the Schmidt trigger before was kind of like the first step on the feedback. That was feeding into the CD4046, but over time it seems like just using the CD4046 by itself works well enough. That's a real handy chip. You know, it's got the VCO on it. You don't have to worry about any type of background oscillator or kickstarting. So long as you don't need any inversion stages, then you know, you just don't even need the hex inverter. You don't need the 5-volt rail at all, basically. 2200 microfarad cap on there now. Audio jack hooked up to the PLL chip. The Bluetooth on there. So the sort of annoying thing about like running this primary, that's where I get the biggest output. It's pretty impressive, I think. It just pulls way too much power. This thing, when it's in the best tuning, it just pulls way too many amps. It's like it wants to pull like 20 amps. So I have to detune it basically, you know, just to be able to run it. So instead of doing that, it's gonna probably run that, and I still have to detune it, but I can detune it and cut it up and then just kind of run less power, still get sort of decent arcs. Yeah, so if I just run it with no music playing and I start to cut it up, I've got it detuned, right? So I have to get way up there before it starts really pulling significant juice. All right. I can basically tune it some more, whoops, to get the breakout. And that's the maximum I've allowed it to tune, basically. So at about that 25 VAC, it already wants to pull like 4 amps or so. Yeah, about 4 amps with that tuning. So if I start cranking it up from there with that tuning, it really starts pulling a lot of juice. So again, found it beneficial to just sort of crank it way back. So I've got it way back to the point where once it starts getting up there in voltage, it's pulling maybe like 10 amps or more. So that's like 11 amps. Right. So that's just sort of how the thing tunes. If I cut it all the way back like that, I can basically bring it all the way up and doesn't want to pull more than about, you know, 12, 13 amps or so. So that's pulling way less juice than it was before when I was just running unsmoothed. Get the crazy discharge there. So that's sort of like compromise I can do with that playing music. And again, just sort of the bonus of the, you know, the smoothed output is pull more silent hot arcs. That's hot. So sort of beneficial there, like if you just want to pull some hot arcs, detuning it like that makes it so, you know, draws very little until you actually get it closer in tune by pulling the arc. So it's kind of like you're not wasting all this power when you're not pulling the arc. By detuning it so hard, then sometimes the shifting of the audio signal coming in will really shift the output. So kind of hard to find good settings there. Make it stop me. Well, again, that's having to restrict the flame back by not having it the highest resonance. And running it like that, it doesn't get too crazy hot, but I can imagine running it like that, running it all the way up for too long would get pretty warm. So that fan is kicked on, it's trying to keep that heat sink a little cool. I sort of need to fine tune these values a little more, but the quality, I haven't really fine tuned the quality or anything like that, but the difference between this and the other smaller ones I've tried is the volume. I actually have to cut the volume back on here, or it's too overpowering, seems like. That's pretty cool. It's from the basic Bluetooth deal again. And again, if I cut it up, you see the way I've got it tuned now, it's just tuned a little closer. So now is where it sort of wants to start pulling, you know, up to like 15 amps when I get it all the way up. But the thing is, that's, you know, clearly that's not anywhere close to the highest tuning, because it was pulling closer to 20 amps, completely unsmoothed, full wave, when I maximized my output. But I think it was just working it just a little bit too hard. So just sort of derating that a little bit seems totally fine. I feel like I've derated it a little bit more than necessary. So again, another option is just use the same primary, but instead of trying to change the impedance, just again, control the power with the resonant frequency here, right? So it's not running completely off feedback at the highest resonance. It's just going to run whatever I sort of lock in at here. Of course, I can interrupt it now. Let's cut that off. But just cut it off. Let it run down from the cap by itself. It actually runs down a good little ways just directly off that capacitor at 2200 microfarad. So that's not bad. Anyway, regular interrupter stuff there. I've investigated this bridge enough. It looks to be running very cleanly, in my opinion. It doesn't have any cross conduction or shoot through any of these problems. It's just the fact that it's pulling mucho juice all the way up, right? So 20 amps or something like that, I really wasn't expecting, but that's what ends up happening.